It's the facilities, culture, and environment of clubs that can get women and girls into sport and keep them playing for the long term, if clubs get it right. In this chapter, we're going to follow Stacey's story, now she's a young mum, as she tries to get back into sport after some time away. You can use what you learn from Stacey's story to identify things that you can do to encourage women and girls to start playing and to stay playing. Firstly, what are the reasons young women may want to play sport? These can include fitness and muscle tone. Some use sport to feel connected and part of a community. Sport is a great way to make friends and have some social contact. Some women turn to sport to assist with forms of depression or anxiety. Stacey always loved playing sport as a girl and as a teen. As is often the case though, after finishing school, Stacey had some time away from sport. But now that she has become a mum, she's keen to get active again and improve her fitness and get back into shape. What can clubs do to make it easy for women like Stacey to connect with them? Firstly, clubs need to have suitable programs to accommodate female participation. Programs need to be flexible, maybe with a focus on participation rather than competition. Perhaps you can use modified fields or rules. Consider less structured social opportunities or casual membership options. Some women like to train to keep up their fitness, but would prefer not to compete on the weekend. As cost can be a prohibiting factor for some women, programs should be affordable. Sports programs for women can be run sustainably, so they shouldn't be a financial burden on clubs. And consider the best time of day for stay-at-home mums, remembering that they are often juggling school pickups with work and dinner time. And how can clubs connect with women? Keep your website and social media presence up to date and relevant for female participation. Where you promote women's opportunities, focus on them being friendly, fun, and for social enjoyment, not just for competition. Preferably, your imagery should include women and girls of all ages and cultures. Network with local workplaces and schools to see if teams can be formed. Take part in local government initiatives. For example, you may be able to offer activities for mums as part of a broader council program. Let's now explore a couple of experiences that clubs can avoid. Imagine that when Stacey was looking for a club to join, she visited one with no female facilities at all. At this club, there may be no women's toilets or change rooms. If there were women's games, they might have been scheduled in the leftover time, like early afternoon or late at night. Times that just don't work around family meal times. This would not be a welcoming facility or environment. And imagine an end of year function where the senior men's team didn't socialise with the women's team. The event would really feel divided, like it had an old-fashioned culture of segregation. Worst of all, if one of the senior women players had brought a friend along who was keen to join the club next year, if she didn't feel welcome, there's a good chance that she would not come back. Supportive environments can be created by ensuring volunteers, committee members, coaches and officials are friendly and welcoming for new people. Spaces for mums should be comfortable. They could include breastfeeding areas, good lighting, and access to a microwave and a fridge. Coaches and referees need good facilities too. They should be clean, accessible, and secure to incentivize women to take on these leadership roles. This also shows that your club has proactively invested. What else could you offer? Professional development opportunities and accredited training for female coaches and officials? Some form of childcare for mums? Maybe reduced participation fees for mums that play and volunteer? Can dads help out sometimes with dinners at the club, such as family barbecues, on training and game nights? Female participation could become a family affair. And can you create opportunities for children, mums and dads to participate at the same time? No childcare needed. Avoid stereotyping potential new members. Imagine a scenario where a new family arrives at a club. If the current volunteers assume that it's the children that are going to join as players and dad might coach while mum goes and works in the canteen, do you think that the family will feel welcomed if it's actually mum who's come along to play and take on a coaching role? As a committee, you can develop and implement policies that truly support female participation in sport. But remember, it's not the words on the page in the policy that make a difference for your members, but how you put them into practice. Consider writing a gender equity policy that spells out your commitment to providing equitable access to facilities and programs for males and females. Appoint mentors for new members. Educate your members about anti-discrimination and anti-harassment laws. When you're planning for the future, create inclusive mission statements and team visions that connect people together. And lead by example. Your club's committee and leaders must be on board and openly support inclusive behaviour and live it. Because Stacey's experiences were positive, her club gave her every opportunity to stay involved as a player and encouraged Stacey's daughter to play as well. So set aside time every 6 months at a committee meeting to review and evaluate your successes and areas where you could do more next time. Remember that data is extremely powerful. You should keep good statistics on gender breakdown of coaches, officials, players and committee members. Then use your data as a reminder of the benefits of increasing female participation, to help with grant applications, and to ensure that you're on track to achieving your club's long-term goals. Involving women and girls in sport is great. It's great for participants and for you as clubs. By adopting some of the tips that we've discussed in these videos, you can create positive change. So involve your committee, coaches, officials, players, and parents to explore how you can best enjoy all of the benefits we've discussed. Document your ideas in a female participation plan. Then involve the leaders in your club to put your projects into action. So, congratulations on creating a female-friendly culture, environment, and facilities. And enjoy the journey.